Hey everyone, Professor Hank here. So today we're going to look at some examples of functions in the C++ algorithms library that allow us to apply our own functions that we write, custom functions that we write, over a series of values or a range of values. So examples we'll look at will include the COUNTIF function, the FOREACH function, and the ALLOF function. So let's get started. Okay, so in order to access these functions, we're of course going to have to hashtag include the algorithm header file, and that's going to give us access to the foreach function we're going to look at, the COUNTIF function we're going to look at, and the ALLOF function that we're going to look at. Now, each of these functions are going to accept three arguments. So the arguments are going to be a starting iterator, an ending iterator, and then a function that we can pass to these functions. So we're going to need starting iterator, ending iterator, and some function, right? So let's take a look at the foreach function first. So with the foreach function, this is going to allow us to perform an operation across a series of values, okay? So let us say that we created a vector of integers. So we'll hashtag include vector there, and then we'll create a vector of integers, and we'll call this a vector v, and we'll just assign to it 8675309. Okay, so what I want to do is I want to apply some function to each of these particular values. So maybe what I do is something as simple as tripling the value of each of the elements of my vector. So let's write a function that can allow us to do that. So we will call this function triplet. How about that? And we're going to have a reference parameter for this function. Okay, so the function's not going to return anything, so we avoid function, and we're going to have a single reference parameter. That is because each one of these elements is essentially going to be passed by reference to the function, and then the function will be able to do its job with that element. In this case, tripling whatever that value is. So we'll just do something like this, n equals n times 3. Okay. Alternatively, we could have used the combined assignment operator here as well, but we'll go with that. Okay. So now let's write a function that will allow us to print out the contents of our vector just to make this a little bit easier. So we'll do something like void print const vector int v, and then we'll just simply print out the contents of that vector. So we'll do something like for auto n v cout, and we'll put a little space between the values, and then new line character, move the character to the next line. Okay, so let us print out the contents of our vector pre application of the foreach function, before we run the foreach function, so we can see what the original contents looks like. Test what we have so far. Okay, so there you have your 8675309. So now we're gonna apply the foreach function. And remember, the first argument is going to be the starting iterator. So I'm going to do all of the values in the vector. So I'm going to do something like this, v dot begin and then v dot end. So I can go through and iterate over the entire vector. And then I'm going to pass my function here, triplet. So that triplet function is going to be applied to each one of these elements in turn. Okay, so let's go ahead and print the result of that afterwards. So print v one more time. So you can see that after foreach ran, the function was applied to every single one of those values, right? So 8 became 24, 6 became 18, 7 became 21, 5 became 15, 3 became 9, 0 tripled is 0 still, 9 became 27. Okay, so we can do that. So now what if I wanted to just triple these three values here? I can do that. I just have to create an iterator that refers to the 7 and then another iterator that refers to the 3 and then plug those in as the first two arguments, right? So let's set that up. So we'll do vector int iterator, and then we'll have a front iterator, which is going to start off at v.begin, but we'll move it. And then we'll need a back iterator, which will start off at v.end, but we'll move that as well. So let us update our front iterator. So we'll do plus equals 2 because I want it to move from here to here. And then I'm going to do it back minus equals two, because I want it to end up right here. Okay. So let's change our arguments, our first two arguments for our for each function. So we'll do it front, and then we'll do it back, and then we'll test that and see what we got. Okay, so now you can see that only the three values in the middle got updated, 21, 15, and 9. Now let's take a look at our next example, and that's going to be an example of the COUNTIF function. And the COUNTIF function is going to go over each individual element and then will count, right? It keeps a counter that will get incremented if your past function evaluates that it should. So let's create a function that will do that. So we will have something like this. We'll do bool. This one's going to have a return type. And then we'll do something like is even. So we'll count up how many values in our vector are even. So we'll pass a single argument, this time by value, because there's no reason to change the contents of our vector here. And then we'll need to have a test. So we will do if n modulus 2 is equal to 0, right? Because something's even if you divide it by 2 and there's nothing left over. If that's true, then we will return true. Otherwise, we'll return false. Okay, so let's go and update our code here to use COUNTIF. So we'll do something like int count equals COUNTIF, and then I want to count the entire vector, right? I want to check every single element in the vector. So we're going to do v.begin, and then we'll do v.end, and then we'll pass as an argument our isEven function right here. So we're going to do isEven. Now, since we're not going to be changing the contents of our vector, let's use constant immutable iterators. And don't forget to put your underscore here between the count and the if. And then we'll go ahead and just print out, you know, the total number of evens here. And then we'll do count. And then move the cursor to the next line. So let's go ahead and run that and test it. Okay, so the total number of evens is 3. Now let's go and double check that that's right. So how many evens are in our vector? There's 8, there's 6, and there's 0. So that is your COUNTIF function. The final example we'll look at is the ALLOF function. And the ALLOF function is going to return true if everything is true, or if something is true about all of the items in your container, in this case, our vector, right? So we're just going to do something like this. We'll do all of, okay? And this thing returns true or false. So we can place that inside of a if statement, use that as our test expression. And then we can say, you know, if all of the items in the container are even, then we'll see out all are even. Otherwise, we'll see out not all are even, right? And we don't need this anymore. So this should be false, right? This should evaluate to false because not everything in here is even, right? Because there's only 3 values that are. So let's go ahead and test that. So you can see it's true that not all are even. Now let's do one more example of this. Let's write a function that just tests for non-negative numbers, right? So we'll do something like bool non-negative, and then we'll pass the value as an argument. And then this will return true if the value is 0 or more, false otherwise. So we'll just return n greater than or equal to 0, something like that. And so then I can use all of again. So we'll do if all of, and then pass to it the first iterator, and then the end, and then the name of the function that we are going to use for our evaluation, right? And that's going to be non-negative. That's what we called it, right? And let's not forget our C there. Okay, and then we will print out an error message. Cout all are none, negative. Otherwise, cout not all are none, negative, something like that. Okay, so just a couple of different examples. So it's what it looks like, making that function call, which returns true or false. We're saying, well, where should you start looking within the container? Where should you stop looking in the container? And what are we checking for here? Or how are we going to check? We're going to check using this non-negative function, which is simply returning true if the value is greater than or equal to zero, therefore being non-negative. Okay, so then you can see in our output, all are non-negative. Now, is that true? Let's take a look at the values in our container. Yeah, that's true. Every single value in our container are not negative numbers. All right, everyone, that's everything that I wanted to cover in this video. So what did we take a look at? We looked at examples of functions in the C++ header file that allow us to apply our own custom functions across a series of numbers. So the functions we looked at were for each, which allowed us to apply a function and change all the values in our vector container. We looked at the COUNTIF, which allowed us to specify counting of elements within our container. So in this case, if they were even was our example. And then we looked at the final example, all of, which returned true or false, depending on whether or not all of the values in the particular container fit some type of criteria. In this case, the numbers were non-negative. So these are just three examples. There's more examples than that in the algorithms header file. There's plenty more options that you have, but they generally work. They all generally work like this. And that is, you know, you pass the starting iterator, you pass the ending iterator, and then some function as an argument that is going to perform some action upon the elements in the container. As usual, if you're a student of mine, you have questions about any of the content in this video or any of the videos in our courses, feel free to stop by my Zoom office hours or email me through Canvas. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.